It's like if you go into a restaurant, and let's assume that you're not a vegetarian and that you are someone who drinks alcohol. You walk into a restaurant and they hand you a 10-page menu. This chicken, these chicken dishes, these beef dishes, these veal dishes, these vegetable dishes, these noodle dishes, 10 pages of alcoholic drinks. You're worried, what do I order? How long does it take to go through the menu? People worry what to order, what not to order. But if you walk into that restaurant and you're a strict vegetarian and you don't drink alcohol, then suddenly the 10-page menu has become this big. Now, instead of 10 pages of things to go through, you have 5 vegetable dishes. Suddenly, instead of the stress and the tension of what to eat, what not to eat, you're focused. Very few choices. Those dietary decisions have filtered out unconsciously. You don't even look at the veal and the beef. You know, I don't eat these things. In the same way, when we make a commitment to living a spiritual life, all of the rest of the nonsense gets filtered out. All of these desires, these fears, these judgments, these jealousies, it gets filtered out. If I'm sitting in a restaurant and I know I don't eat beef, it doesn't matter to me how the beef is cooked. I'm not going through this beef or that beef. It's not even an option. I'll flip through the page without even looking at it. In the same way, all of these thoughts that flood our mind that we don't know what to do with when we sit for meditation, when we lie in bed at night and we can't go to sleep, if we've made a commitment to a deep spiritual life, then all of these things automatically get filtered. The brain says no. Like with the vegetarian or the non-alcohol, the brain says no. Immediately, before it even gets into your consciousness, I don't think. But that commitment is required. I want to end by sharing a story of 3 men who were on a boat in the ocean. And they're lost on the boat. And what they've done, they've divided the boat into 3 sections so that each one has his own part of the boat. And they say, here are our invisible lines. You can't cross onto my third. I won't cross onto your third. At least now, boat may be small, but we all have our piece. One day, one of the 3 men starts to try to hammer a hole into the bottom of his part of the boat. The other 2 men start to panic. What are you doing? We'll drown. He says, no, no, don't worry. I'm only hammering the hole in my part of the boat. Clearly, even though they've drawn these make-believe lines in the boat, the hole in one part is going to cause them all to sink. In our lives, we also have these imaginary, invisible, not real lines between our physical life, our emotional, mental life, and our spiritual life. We pay a lot of attention to taking care of ourselves physically, to taking care of ourselves emotionally. But many of us are drilling that hole in the spiritual part of the boat. And the moment that that hole is there, the whole boat sinks. Until and unless we make a very, very strong commitment to keep that part of the boat in as much tact and as whole as the other 2 parts of the boat, we'll never stay afloat. When we make that commitment, then we'll be able to really live in our true nature of peace. The chaos automatically will start to dissipate and vanish. When we are focused on that third of the boat, the other 2/3 will take care of themselves.
Watch more. Log on to www.erosentertainment.com.